Cataract surgery and the high myopia. What you should know about the lens selection options, what is the specific of the disease, and what visual outcomes you might expect with different IOLs, and what limiting factors you might be facing with in case of your disease while talking with your doctor. Hi there, my name is Alexey, and you're at IOL-adviser, Eye Surgery Explained channel. In my previous video, I've talked about the low to mild myopia and explained the difference between, let's say, your visual experience before the surgery and the visual experience you might expect after the surgery. What is the difference of high, extremely high myopia, let's say minus 9, minus 12, whatever, in that ranges? First of all, the problem of that type of high myopia is that the eyeball normally is larger than normal, way larger than normal. What does it mean? It means that we have more media inside of the eye, which light which goes inside of your eye through the pupil, which has to pass to reach the retina. And as you know, we are seeing by using our retina, which, let's say, feels the incoming light rays and transfer to the brain. And of course, as you might imagine, the more light we have inside of the eye, the better image quality we have. And the problem is that our eye is filled with the different medias. In the anterior chamber of the eye, we have kind of water, let's call it water, it's aqueous humor, and a specific liquid which helps to feed cornea and keeps your eye pressure at normal level. And what is more important, the posterior chamber of the eye, let's say the vast majority of eyeball volume, is filled with so-called vitreous body. It is a kind of jellyfish substance which is supporting the eyeball shape, keeps it healthy, etc. And the problem is that this media should be transparent. And in many cases, high myopic patients have certain, let's say, specific changes in this media, which might be called floaters, and even healthy patients sometimes experiencing floaters. And this media is not fully transparent. And sometimes if we have a vitreous degeneration process, like vitreous detachment, or we have more floaters, etc. So the more media, the more, let's say, an ideal media we have, the less light passes through the retina. And it might reduce the contrast sensitivity. It might reduce the amount of light and quality of vision. And it is one of the first and important reasons why extremely high myopic patients are not, let's say, good candidates for full range of vision lenses. I've just mentioned something which you might be not aware of. I said a full range of vision lenses, and probably you don't understand what does it mean. And to make it easier for you, I just tell you shortly that we have four type of intraocular lenses, range from monofocal to extended monofocal to extended range of vision lenses and full range of vision lenses. Please have a look to the description to this video. You will have a links here to my other videos explaining different IOLs types. And if you are first to my channel, just have a look to the description to this video below. You will find the links to useful videos explaining the different IOL types, and even a few different models. And what is more important, I have a dedicated website called IOLadvisor.com, where you can read about the different IOL types, different IOL models, and you can try to select the optimal IOL selection, optimal IOL option for your particular visual needs, based on specifically designed IOL questionnaire, which is automatically, let's say, explained to you as a patient based on your responses to different questions. And you can try this IOL questionnaire as a starting point, which will guide you to the discussion with your doctor about the IOL options available. I encourage you to use it to print the results, to send it to your doctor and to discuss, because the questions here are based on well-known Dr. Del IOL questionnaire, which is widely used in the ophthalmology. And it will help to save your time and time of your doctor to discuss about different IOL options. What is important for you to understand in cases of high myopia, you might be limited in terms of IOL type selection. Because, first of all, as I mentioned, we have the vitreous body, which might be not healthy enough to transfer enough light, especially at very extremely high diopters. And some type of full range vision lenses might not be suitable for you because they reduce amount of light reaching the retina. And if it's not a big problem for a healthy eye, for extremely large eye, when you have the dense media of vitreous body, which might be also affected by floaters, the amount of light reduced by lens and by vitreous body might be too low to let's say, put this lens safely, because in a bright sunny day you might be okay, but in dim light conditions your contrast sensitivity, your amount of light might drop below the healthy threshold, and your vision quality might be very much degraded, and you will be not happy at all with that selection. Another point, if you are talking about the high myopia, it is the optical power of the lenses available. What is optical power? We have cornea, we have lens, and we have eyeball. And the cornea and the lens, they are optical lenses, which are designed to focus all the incoming light rays to the retina. And if the optical power of cornea and the lens is not fitting the eyeball size, you have myopia, hyperopia, astigmatism, etc. And in case of high myopia, we have to select an IOL which will be fitting to this eyeball size, and together with the cornea, which will focus light rays on the retina. And the problem is that not every lens is available in the specific diopters which might be needed for high myopia patients. Sometimes it is possible to make you fully ametropic, to be glasses free for far distance. And it's important to discuss here with your doctor, how would you like to live your life after the surgery? Would you be spectacle independent at far? Would you like to be spectacle independent at near? Or you would like to have the maximum range of vision without glasses? Because with a high myopia or with a low myopia, with any eye diseases, when you implant the artificial lens, intraocular lens or IOL, you are losing the natural accommodation mechanism. I've explained about that many times, but if you are first time in my channel, just to have an idea, so your natural lens is changing its power to give you different distances from your eye to be accessible without glasses. And after the surgery, this function is not available anymore, and you need to call pseudo-accommodation, which give you kind of spectacle independent range of vision. So coming back to high myopia, it might be a problem of light rays coming through the dense media. Second, it might be a problem of lack of diopters of specific lens, which will give you, let's say, desired ametropia or even low myopia. So it depends on your medical conditions and lenses choices available at particular location. And the third problem, which I would like to mention, is cases of astigmatism in cases of high myopia. In that cases, many patients might have astigmatism as well. And for astigmatism correction, we need a toric lens, which corrects the astigmatism of the cornea. What does astigmatism? What does the toric lens? Again, I have a dedicated video, so I wouldn't waste time right now. Again, in the description and in this corner, I will put the video about the astigmatism and toric lenses. But general idea, you have to understand, you, let's say, take home message from that video, that the toric lens shall be placed in the specific, let's say, angle to compensate corneal astigmatism. And if you're talking about high myopia patients, the eyeball is relatively large, and the place when we put the intraocular lens is relatively large as well. When we put the intraocular lens, we put it inside of so-called capsular bag, which holds your natural lens, and then we put artificial lens inside. And this capsular bag is holded inside of the eye by so-called zonulas or zonal fibers, which keeping the eye, the natural lens or artificial lens in the place. And in high myopic patients, these zonulas may be weak or damaged. And it means that lens is not, let's say, securely fixed, and it might rotate, might shake, might dislocate. And for that particular reason, surgeons using so-called capsular tension ring, which should be implanted inside of the eye to keep your eyes more stable, to keep the lens in perfect condition. And this specific also might limit the IOL selection and technology selection in your particular case. So if you have a high myopia, I advise you to discuss deeper with your doctor lens options, lens selection process, and to be ready to accept that sometimes not everything is possible. In majority of cases, with any IOL which will be implanted in your eye, you will have a better vision outcomes that you had before without glasses. It's that for sure, because extremely high myopic patients in some cases are virtually blind, because let's say with minus 10 you can see anything normal at far, you can even have a big problems navigating without the glasses or contact lenses inside of your house. And with any IOL selected, your vision will be better. But in these cases, the most important to try to select the most optimal lens, which will restore your vision to the maximum in terms of visual acuity for far, for intermediate, and for near. So I wish you a good vision, and I hope your surgeon will help you to get the best visual correction, the best visual outcomes after the cataract with your astigmatism, high myopia, and to be as spectacle-free as possible.